courteous coders. My name is Shawn, and I will be your instructor today. You're watching the Coding with Shawn channel. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to fix the PyCharm error, where it may say invalid Python interpreter, import error, or no interpreter. So, let's go ahead and get started. However, before we begin fixing the error, I do want to say this is not a part of either my Python for Beginner series, my Data Science and Machine Learning series, or any other series. So just know that this is a special edition just for anybody who may have gotten this error or something like it. So with that, let's go ahead and hop into the solution part. So the first thing we have to do is actually understand the problem thoroughly, because as programmers, we want to deeply understand any error or issue so that we can properly fix that next time and understand it for future reference. So, this error is caused because of Python, not because of PyCharm. Chances are that either the Python installed on your system got corrupted, or the Python that's on your system got deleted. So, let's talk about how we can easily fix that. So the first thing I want you to do is click the link in the description below and watch my video on how to install Python, because I want you to install a fresh copy of Python regardless of whether you have a copy of Python on your system or not, because you need a new fresh copy. That should fix it in itself, but if it still doesn't, then let's continue. So the next thing I want you to do is come over here to this side and click on this button, which is called Configure Python Interpreter. Just give that a left click, and then it'll bring this box up for you. So you can see that there are two buttons, Interpreter Settings and Add Interpreter. I want you to click on the Interpreter Settings button, because that is the one where we are going to fix your corrupted file or your missing file. Okay, once you've done that, it'll bring you to something that looks like this. Now, notice how for me it says that my Python interpreter is invalid. That means that either my Python file is corrupted or that PyCharm does not want to use this on a given project or file for some reason. So it's still a pretty simple fix. Go ahead and click this button right here. Okay, then you will see two things: no interpreter and show all. You might see other things, but I want you to click on the show all button. This may be at the bottom, so you may need to do a little scrolling, but make sure that you are clicking on the show all button. That should bring you to a screen that's called Python interpreters. Here, I only see one. You may see many, but just follow along with me for a moment here. You will see a button which has a plus symbol on it. I want you to click on that button with this plus symbol. Then it'll bring you to this screen called Add Python Interpreter. Now, there are a couple of different things on the screen. There's the virtual ENV environment, the conda environment, the system interpreter, and the pip ENV environment. So, we are not dealing with conda here, we are not dealing with pip, and we are not trying to fix our virtual environment right now. We want to focus on our system interpreter because we want to make sure we have the proper version of Python selected. Therefore, we want to click on this button called System Interpreter. Then it'll bring you to this rather simple screen. There's interpreter and then a version here. So you click here, and then you might see a couple of different versions of Python, but if you've installed the most recent version of Python on your computer, then you should see Python 3.9 or something above that. So go ahead and click Python 3.9 or something above that if you're watching this in the future, and then click OK. Now, this is a very important step. Make sure that Python 3.9 is highlighted in blue. If this is highlighted in blue, the invalid one, then make sure you click on this Python 3.9 one to make sure that it is the one highlighted in blue, because if it is not, then you're just going to end up selecting the invalid one again. So go ahead and click Python 3.9 and then click OK. Now you'll see that there are a couple more packages here, but don't worry about that. Just make sure that your Python interpreter is set to Python 3.9 or whatever you installed just now. After that, simply click OK here in the bottom right corner. Now, give PyCharm a second to get everything set, and once you have, let's go ahead and run our file. And you can see, voila, it works like magic. So, I hope that fixed your error. If it did not, fear not, just leave a comment in the comment box below and I will personally help you fix your problem. However, this should have fixed your problem if you're in the 99.9% of people. Thank you very much for watching, and if you did have your problem fixed, please do like, share, and subscribe to support us and so you can help other people. And from here, I'd like to point you into the direction of either my Python for Beginners series or my Data Science and Machine Learning series. In my Python for Beginners series, I start from the very, very basics, and I teach you up from there. So if you're a beginner, please start from my Python for Beginners series. If you already know Python and you have the hang of it, no problem. Go ahead and head over to my Data Science and Machine Learning series, where I will teach you some more advanced topics, and no matter where you are on your journey to learn Python, I can help you. So be sure to go ahead and move on to one of those series next. Aside from that, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in another video soon.